alongside that dream. I want to see what we can do to make this happen. You were in eighth grade at the time. Since that time, Mason, with the help of a lot of people who have wanted to help him pursue his dream, has spoken at the Warsaw Community Schools opening day, to which he received a standing ovation. Has spoken at Grace College Chapel, to which he received a standing ovation, which was one of the six they had in the history of chapel. He's spoken at Franklin College at a graduation ceremony. He spoke at North Webster Elementary and invited him out. Lincoln Elementary, Claypool Elementary, Tri-Kappa Scholarship Night, Adult Education Conference for Northern Indiana, and he is so fired up to bring his message to the new educators that we are so blessed to have in Kosciusko County. So would you give a warm welcome to my friend and inspiration, Mason Metzger.
And so strength. And this verse not only gives me guidance, but it helps me overcome obstacles. And when the world tells me I can't do something, that this verse reminds me that I can do anything. So, for the past 2 summers, I have attended the CLIU conference at Hope College in Pauline, Michigan. This conference has helped me grow in so many ways. It's helped me grow in my faith and also with my peers. So it's just been really cool. And I'm going to share some of the things I've learned at the conference with you today. So the first topic I would like to talk about is unity. I want to tell you that we are equal. It doesn't matter how long you have been teaching. You all bring new ideas and new skills to the table, and I want to encourage you to be innovative. And something I also learned at the MOOC conference is when we are united, walls come down, chains break, and we are able to have a culture of positivity where new ideas or ways to accomplish goals can flow freely. And one of the words the speaker used was shlow, and I bet this word comes from the Hebrew, and I adapted it to fit my message today. So I said that shlow means peace, feeling complete, feeling true joy, and being at peace with others. And there is so much hurt and violence in the world today, and I couldn't imagine if everyone could just put their differences aside and build each other up instead of tearing down the culture of positivity, how our world would change, how our schools would change, and how the world would change. And I have this new desire to be bold in everything that I do, and I want to encourage you to do the same. So now I'm going to talk about overcoming obstacles. I have faced both internal and external challenges in my life. One of the biggest challenges that I faced in my life was when my dad had testicular cancer. And on the day that I met Mrs. Klein, my dad was actually having a surgery. And during that time, I was lost. I lost hope, and I put on a mask that made it look like I was doing okay on the outside, but on the inside, I was hurting. But that didn't stop me from inspiring others. And during that time, I was afraid to ask for help in my struggle because I had always asked for help academically, but in other areas in my life, I didn't know how to ask for help. So I was following the pattern of this world, and at MOOC 2015, I realized that I was in chains of darkness, and I could not climb this mountain alone. I needed someone with a greater power than I. So at that conference in 2015, I was delivered from that struggle, and then this summer, I realized at the conference that we had been given 2 tools in order to overcome obstacles. Number one is the word of God, and number two is the power of prayer. And I want to tell you to never give up. We are a team. We are united. We can overcome obstacles together. So now I want to talk about leadership. And so when I was preparing for this speech, I thought of a quote. I said, no matter where you are on the team, you still have the same amount of influence. Each of you can make a difference in the lives of both your students and your colleagues. We are all leaders. We all have gifts, talents, and skills that we can use to lead others. And I want to tell you, even the small things you can do to lead others mean just as much as the big things. And I have learned that we need to have a growth mindset, both academically and in other areas of our lives, because we all have room to grow. If you have a growth mindset, the people you are around are more likely to have them. And when we all have a growth mindset, you guys help students achieve their dreams. So I have had multiple people in my life, my teachers especially, who have taught me that I can overcome whatever obstacle or challenge. And you guys give students hope when they don't have confidence in themselves. So my teachers have always found a way for me to accomplish something. It may take me a little bit longer, but I can still get to the same end goal. So, in conclusion, we are united. As new teachers, you are going to face challenges, but I just want to encourage you to be bold, be innovative, come up with new ideas, and just do your best. I want to tell you to never give up. You all have the power to make a difference. And the last analogy I want to leave you today that I have become very passionate about is helping students transform from caterpillars to a butterfly. So when I think of that caterpillar thing, I think of someone is trying to find what they're passionate about, and then they finally kind of get on this mission, and they break out of their shell. And I can tell you that I have grown in so many ways, and I am finally becoming a butterfly. So,
Mason embodies solution-focused attitude. And that's what we need in education. We need people that look at any kind of person in front of them and see the good, and see the potential, and see the possibility. And they look at, I might have an obstacle, I might have a problem, but you know what, there's a solution to this. And it may be my best growth opportunity as I work through this. So I want to thank you, Mason. I want to thank you for how you've inspired me and how you've inspired others today. And I know that it comes from the heart when you say people like them have made all the difference for you. So, thank you. We give a warm round of applause.